think that in the second term of Lula, there were possibilities to begin a process of transformations, like the other South Americans. But he didn't do it. On foreign policy, they improved, there's no doubt about it. So they refused to allow Brazil just to be a country which does what the Americans want. They refused to allow Brazil to be used to destabilize Bolivia or Venezuela. That's true, and that's a good thing, and that marks a shift. But internally, not much has been done. And the Bolsa Familia is a tiny palliative, and it's not going to work in the long run. And, you know, people go on talking endlessly about the favelas and the society it produces. Well, there is a solution. Create a better society in which people who now live in favelas don't have to live there. It can be done. There is enough wealth in the country to do it. But when you're in a country where the rich don't pay any taxes, there's a problem. And then you have to pay, you have to say to the rich, you people are earning too much money. You don't make that much money, you earn a lot more money proportionately than what you make for the country. And the social disparity between rich and poor continues to increase. It doesn't decrease. And this is a wrong method. You know, it's not going to work. We need a different method from you. I have to be honest with you. I mean, I'm very happy, of course, that Serra didn't win, that Dilma won. But that goes without saying. But when I saw a picture of her with Palazzi standing next to her, I did feel, oh my God. Because this is a guy who is the most articulate defender of neoliberal economic policies. You don't need people like him now. You need people who think differently.